والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, welcome to the روضة الجنة. This is how Rasulullah called it, this majlis ilm. And if, of course, we cannot see them and you cannot touch them, Malaika confirm 100% are here. They all they have the whenever you enter, they just write your name. Alhamdulillah. And all this going to be for you and for us, Yawmul Qiyamah, as a shahada. And this is what Rasulullah read when he read Surat إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. Then he asked Sahaba, مَا أَخْبَارَهَا? What is the earth going to talk about? They say, Allah wa Rasulu A'lam. Allah knows. He say, يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, the earth is going to tell everyone, going to talk, Mr. A walk from his house today is Saturday, and brother could go to enjoy himself like we say somewhere else, can read at home, can watch TV. Today is Saturday, working for 5 days, but still he has a time to think for Allah, walk from very far to come here for nothing except for Allah. Then Allah is going to say this, going to mention, and Asafullah, someone else did something negative, going to talk about this, all this. So these are the things going to be recorded down in our sigil. So I will tell myself and to you all, congratulations to, and we hope inshallah we'll meet sometime from time to time to this kind of majlis. And today inshallah we'll be talking or discussing, I like to talk it discussing about Surat Hujurat. Surat Hujurat. Hujurat is in Arabic name Hujra. Hujra means room. One. Plural is Hujurat. And when the ayah surah say Hujurat, mean the rooms or the houses of Rasulullah's wife's house. Rasulullah's wife. So before to make tafsir, to understand any surah, without understanding the context of the surah, it won't be complete. So you need to understand when and how and why the surah was revealed to Rasulullah to give you a general idea, to give you a right idea about the surah. So Surat Hujurat is a madaniya. When we say madaniya, you know Quran is a, as you know, we make a Quran. Example, Quran, we have a Makkiya. I know all of you generally know Jawiya, Makkiya and Madaniya. Now this is Makkiya and Madaniya. And then the ulama, they divided Quran into three parts. Ulama divided Quran into three main subjects. The first is Aqidah. And second is Qissa, history. These are the two parts. This is all Quran of Makkah. And then here is Ahkam, Hukum. Ahkam, or Hukum. So these are the three main topics in Quran. So two are from Makkah, and one is Medina. And we ask, this is a brief introduction to understand the context of the surah or surah Hujurat, and for you to understand properly. So why Quran of Makkah only talking about Aqidah
and history. And then in Quran of Mecca, you are not going to find any farida. When you say farida, any, you know, when you say farida, zakat, saum, all this, only salat came in the end of year 10. But saum and zakat, all are in Medina. Why? Why like this? You know, Mecca was under Quraysh. And the first thing Allah wanted to do, a sahaba, they were in trouble. So Allah didn't want to impose, put on them, ahkam thing, do, don't do. Just want to form them to make strong the akidah. Imagine, we are sitting now, someone enter, wearing sarong, t-shirt, and slipper. Then he say, I'm from Putrajaya. The PM sent me to you. He having bag. He say, I have something in the bag. The PM sent me to you. Logic. Can we believe him? Logic, generally no. It can be right, can be wrong. But when you look at him, he doesn't have someone who just made the PM, right? He's wearing sarong, t-shirt, nothing. So this is how, in the case of all Anbiya, all prophet, when they come first, they are always from very poor. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to call him Yatim Abu Talib. He was poor, nothing. He has nothing. So Quraysh say, why Allah should send you? You are poor, you have nothing. Why Allah should send you? Allah could send someone else. They mentioned two names, Allah, Walid ibn Mughira and Urwa ibn Mas'ud. But they couldn't accept Rasulullah Muhammad is the Nabi. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted Quraysh and people of Mecca to accept the word La ilaha illallah first. Because if they don't accept that you are from Putrajaya, how can they say, how can you tell them the PM said this, the government said that? They won't never accept. You must convince them first that I'm from Putrajaya. The PM sent me to you. When they accept, okay, what the PM say, then I open my bag and I give you what he say. But if they don't accept, no way they will tell me, they will ask you what he say, right? So in Mecca, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam never talk about ahkam. He just was talking about aqidah. Make them accept aqidah. Of course, during this time, he will have some problem. They will insult him. They will do bad thing to him. And the best thing for him, the history. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send history to him, and history of Nabi, before the old prophet, to tell him, cool down. What happened to you? You are not the first one. Happened to all Nabi. So these are the main point, the main reason. In Quran, Mecca, only have aqidah. The most important thing, and history is a kind of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pushing him. Can you imagine, for example, I used to tell my student, for example, when you're in campus for one semester, before entering the university, we tell you, okay, the first condition to study here, for 3 months, you are going to be here, you don't bali kampung, you don't call your mother, your parents, no contact, they don't contact you, you don't go out, all. No contact for 4 years. Who will accept to come to that university? Nobody, of course. Because during not only 4 years, 3 months only, you need to call your mother. Only 1 week, sometimes a lot of trouble with your ustaz, professor, assignment, all this. Morally, you come down. So you need to talk to your parents, to your mother especially. So these are the main reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always in Mecca. When Rasulullah is in problem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send any surah talking about. That's why you find in Quran all surah talking about Nabi in Mecca. All surah talking about prophet in Mecca. So 13 years, you don't find any hukum except salat, of course. So Quran Mecca is only based on aqidah and history. So hukum, we come to it later on. And It was a Makkah was considered as the engine of the Jazira Arabia, the Arab countries. So everything passed through Makkah. So there is now a problem in Makkah itself, family problem. Quraysh against one of their son, named Muhammad, pretend to be Nabi. So we, the rest of Arab, they are outside, far, they say, we let them, we see who will win. They didn't, no Arab country, not Arab tribe, in during Makkah, whoever anti-Islam, anti-individually. No tribe who accept Islam in Makkah as a group. All of them scared of Quraysh. Because it's like, if Quraysh knows that you, they used to, what they used to do, they will put people in the entrance of Makkah. Whoever come, this is our condition. And don't talk to this man. He's a crazy man. He's a blah, 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 blah. And a few of them, like Abu Dhar, is someone strange. He came for 3 days, for 15 days. He came, he wanted to know who is Muhammad. He stayed in Kaaba. He cannot talk to anyone. He cannot ask anyone. He cannot, for 15 days, 2 weeks in Bukhari, he used to only drink Zamzam. Because he's scared. He talk, if they, of course, they know this is a foreigner. He's not from Makkah. So they are observing you. If you talk to any Bani Hashim, and then they are going to kill you. So Abu Dhar came for 2 weeks, staying in Kaaba, eating, not eating, drinking Zamzam. In the end of these days, Ali saw him. He said, look like you are not from here. He said, yes. And then tomorrow he saw him again. He said, no time for the strange man to go back home. Then he told Ali, if you keep it secret, I will tell you why I'm here. Ali said, okay, go ahead, I promise. He said, I heard that there is one man here. He came, he said, he's a prophet. I want to meet him. Ali said, you are lucky. Follow me. But if, this is in Bukhari, huh? Ali said, if I will go, if I see anyone, I suspect him, he may hurt you, I will do, macam I'm arranging my kasut. So that you pass. Because if they see him with Ali, they will know that he want to see Muhammad. So Ali told him, just follow me. If I see anyone, I just pretend I'm doing something to my kasut. So only this is how Abu Dhar met Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Abu Dhar entered Rasulullah's house. Then Rasulullah told him, okay, this is Islam. By the way, when Rasulullah asked Abu Dhar, where are you from? He said, Qabilatu Ghaffar. Qabilatu Ghaffar were known as the gangster tribe of Arab. They were gangster. The Makanan, how they get it? Kidnapping people, selling people, and then get this how the income. This the when he said Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was shocked. He said, Allah yahdi man yasha. Allah guide whoever he want, because he couldn't imagine that a tribe like his family could accept Islam, because they were gangster, the tribe of Bani Abu Dhar. So Rasulullah told him, you go back to your country, and whenever you hear that we become the strongest, you come back. Abu Dhar said, no way, I'm going to make them listen to Islam. So Abu Dhar went to Kaaba and start to read Quran. They came, all Quraysh came on him, start beating him. He was lucky that Abbas, the uncle of Rasulullah Sallam, who the one came, say, do you know who you are beating? You are beating one, someone from Bani Ghaffar. If you kill him, your business finish. Because you cannot pass there your business during when you are doing, Allah says, Rihla Tashitai was safe. So Quraysh, when they are doing business, they are passing in many countries. So Abbas told them, if you kill him, say bye-bye to your business. They are going to their tribe, they are gangster. So they stop. So this is how Quraysh blocked Makkah. So all the tribe in Jazira Arabia, they were scared of Quraysh. So they say we will leave Muhammad with his family, Quraysh. Whoever wins, we will follow him. So in Mecca, can you imagine, until year 7 Hijrah, after Hijrah, I'm 13 years in Mecca, 7 years in Medina, year six, the number of Muslims didn't reach 2,000. Then after 21 years, those who went to Medina for Mecca for Umrah, they were 1,400 after 20 plus years. And all of them scared of Quraysh. So Quraysh, this is what they were doing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you remember Surah Idha Ja'a Nasrullah al-Fath, وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give a sign to Rasulullah sallam, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ. Allah said to Rasulullah sallam, when you see people accept Islam, all the countries in Jazira Arabia, this will be the end of your life. Allah said to Rasulullah sallam, you will die soon after that. This is the tafsir of the ayah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in year 8 capture Mecca. In year 9 we call it Amul Wufud, year of the delegation, because all the tribe in Jazira Arabia were waiting for the winner between Mecca and Medina, or Quraysh and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in the year 8 Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam capture Mecca, so all Jazira Arabia, they have to follow Medina, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So year nine, all the tribe of Jazira Arabia, they have to come to Medina, then to do bay'ah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bay'ah is like this. Or Rasulullah will sit, the chief of all tribe will come and do bay'ah. Meaning all the countries will be under Medina Munawwara. So it is during this time, when tribes start to come, Rasulullah one day was in his house, in the room of one of his wife. Some tribe they came, you know, we call them Arab. They are not that civilized like people of Mecca or Medina. They come from kampung, a kind of safulazim, no manner. So they come, they start to call, Ya Muhammad! Ya Muhammad! I mean, this is a leader, this is a prophet, this is Rasulullah sallam. Have a good manner, be polite, wait for him to come. Or no, they came, Ya Muhammad, come to us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't accept this. So this is the ayah, the surah, going to say surah Hujurat. This is what this the ayah, the surah is going to talk about. How the manner. So we just now mentioned Al-Aqidah. In Mecca, we have Aqidah and history of all the prophets. And then in Medina, all the hukum of Islam are from here in Medina. For 10 years. Now to for any country, we need three things to build a country. We need the land, we need people, and then we need the constitution. So in Mecca did not belong to Muslim. They were doing their ibadah and the pressure, they are hiding themselves. And so no constitution. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just want to build the Aqidah first. Only when they came to Medina, now they have land. Medina, Rasulullah is the president. And all Sahaba surrounding him, they are free now. And the constitutions have to come. When we say ahkam, is the mu'amalat, in all the way of life. All the ahkam in politics, in civil life, all the surah in Medina. All ahkam, political life, how we married us, all our life is in Medina. So Surah Al-Hujurat are talking about this kind of thing. Six recommendations from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the way, when we say Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He was Rasulullah this is something we have to understand. Allah says in Surah Najm, وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Rasulullah doesn't say anything unless it's wahi from Allah. But it doesn't mean that everything Rasulullah talk is wahi. Because what you have to know, Rasulullah himself is a three in one. Three personality in one. Meaning, Rasulullah is not 100% always Rasulullah, whatever he say is from Allah. No. Rasulullah is a Muhammad human being, is a president or prime minister, and is Nabi. So we Muslim, we are asked to follow Rasulullah. We are not asked to follow Muhammad or president. You have to be different. You have to be careful. I mean, three personality, we call three personality in one. What does it mean? A young man say to his father, 20 years old boy, or 22, maybe Elias, want to get married. Then the father said, no, you are not yet 25. Why 25? Because Rasulullah Salam married at age of 25. Is it sunnah this? No, it's not sunnah. Because he married as Muhammad. He didn't marry as Rasulullah. So you don't have to confuse. Rasulullah, he married before he became prophet. He was human being, Muhammad. So, but if I, now my father say, not me, example. And my father say, married. 22, no. Abi, I want to marry at age of 25. Why? Because Rasulullah married. This is up to you. You have a pahala ajr, but it's not sunnah. But because you love too much Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you want to follow everything, this is up to you. Or else, we should tell you, make sure your wife is 40 years old. As Khadija. Eh? No. So, whatever Rasulullah did as before prophecy is not considered as sunnah. But if you want to do it, up to you. But it's not sunnah. And we come to the second. He's a president. Sometimes Rasulullah will say something. He didn't say it as a prophet. He didn't say it as a... Again, I will give you another example as Muhammad. In Sahih Muslim, you know, people of Makkah, Rasulullah originally from Makkah. Makkah people, they don't know paddy field, kurma, or they only know business. They go to Sham and Ordon and buy things, come and sell. Medina people, they know this kind of thing. They don't do business, but they have this kurma. So, different mentality. Rasulullah grew up in Makkah. When he came in Medina, one day he saw Al-Ansar on the Poko Kurma doing Talqih. Talqih is like Allah mentioned in Surah Hijr. Talqih come naturally, angin, ambe kurma male to kurma or anything male to female. Because we modern people, I mean, we don't know the difference between orange male, orange female, or kurma male. But there is a kurma female, kurma male, everything. Allah said in Quran, wa min kulli shay'in khalaqna zawjayn, everything in life is a male and female. So we have the natural way where Allah said in Quran, the angin will take the male to female. Then we'll make a production. So Rasulullah Al-Ansar, they know this thing. They will take the nai, the poko, they take the kurma. Khadija, sit down. They take kurma female, a male to kurma female. And then Rasulullah saw them, what are you doing? They say, we are doing talqih. Then Rasulullah told them, tapaya, no need to do it. If you don't do it also, okay. So Sahaba, they are now in process of learning. They thought it was a wahi, revelation from Allah. They stopped. And then the production of kurma that year, when Rasulullah was giving kurma in Makan, find something different. He said, what is wrong with your kurma this year? They say, ya Rasulullah, you told us to don't do the talqih. Then he said, no. I just say it with my opinion. What's just opinion? It's not wahi, you say. If I tell you something from, if I want to build this house, I don't go and ask the imam or mufti. I go and ask the engineer, the one in charge. He will do. But if I want to ask something halal haram, I go and ask imam. If my motorcycle or my aircon rosa, I don't ask the imam. I call. So Rasulullah SAW say, I just told you with my own opinion, but you know better the way of your life. Meaning, I didn't tell you this as a revelation. So Rasulullah talks sometimes as a Muhammad, human being. And sometimes he talks as a political leader. Example, Rasulullah said in Hadith, or during, if you remember, Ghazwat Badr, Rasulullah, when he came, he sits somewhere, one Sahabi came to him, say, hey Rasulullah, you sit here with the army, is it from your own opinion or from Allah? And then Rasulullah said, no, I just sit here, my own opinion. He said, no, ya Rasulullah, this is not a good place for the army. We go somewhere, called Badr, at the Ai, we take the water, and then you block, this is a strategy of war. You block the enemy to come, and then, so we can find, then Rasulullah follow him. Meaning, when he come to the country, how to deal, I think, we have a meeting, we have the, I listen to you, even though I'm the president or whatever, I listen to you. So Rasulullah was dealing there as a prime minister or as a president. In another hadith, Rasulullah said, Man ahya ard al mawad, whoever clean up a jungle, then the land become his. I mean, when you are going back Balai Kampung, you see sometimes jungle. So Rasulullah said, if you go and clean, cut the trees, clean, the land is yours. Rasulullah said this hadith as a prophet or as a leader? Leader. Because if you say as a prophet, very easy. Tomorrow I just go to any place, jungle, I cut the tree, I build my company, my house, and when the police come, I say, no, see hadith sahih. Rasulullah say, no way. When I want land, what I do, I go to the DBKL, right? Or I go wherever. See, this is under the government. So there is, you must know, Rasulullah said this as a prophet or as a human being. But the third one, Rasulullah said, talk as a Nabi. And then this is the one Allah said, he doesn't make a mistake. Then this one is Masum. And when he talk as Muhammad, he can, he's different. When he talk as a leader, he can listen to us. But when you talk about Allah, halal wa haram, no. Sami'na wa ata'na. So these are the three personality of Rasulullah SAW. Okay, three in one. So we have to know when this is the job of the ulama. But sometimes there is confusion. Rasulullah says something, and we are not sure whether he said it as a Nabi or as a leader, as a government, something like that. Like in Bukhari, Hind, the wife of Abu Sufyan, came to Rasulullah SAW and said, Ya Rasulullah, Abu Sufyan, my husband, is a orang kedekut, very stingy, bakhil. Haji bakhil. Can I take his ATM card, ATM, huh? And go to take his money to buy grocery? Because if I... Can you imagine, 20 years ago, the grocery is how much, one for 2, 3, 5 member of family, and after 20 years, is it the same? Everything, every 2, 3 years, thing increases in the price. So he's still giving the same thing, or he doesn't give. So he went to, in Bukhari, she went to complain to Rasulullah. He's a very kedekut. Haji Bakhil, ya Rasulullah. What should I do? Can I take his money without his information? Because it's the knowledge or what to do. Then Rasulullah SAW say, take what you need and your family, your children. If I know the grocery, we have 5 in the family, the grocery for 1 week, I need 300. Just take 300. Don't take 350 to go and buy no. Haram. This extra is haram. Rasulullah SAW, the ulama now asking, is Rasulullah said this hadith in Bukhari à ses rasouls ou à ses leaders. And then we leave it to point. Because is there any good wife, good woman who want to put in TV the problem with her husband? If you say Rasulullah say as a Rasulullah, if the husband doesn't give you what you need, this is between you and him. You don't need to go and complain to the mahkamah. Because if you go to complain mahkamah, it will be like Rasulullah say as a leader, political leader. So this dispute will be solved by the government, by anybody, any institution. But this is between you and him, your husband. And is there any problem? Just taking the money and then don't. But if you say no, Rasulullah said this as a leader. So whenever he doesn't give you money, the money of a grocery, you just go to the mahkamah, complain, and then tomorrow we read it in the newspaper. And you talk, oh, that lady, oh, this is the one, her husband. This, and of course, we don't like this. So it will be up to you to this part. It's not everything is clear. It will be up to you. You want to hear this hadith to be Rasulullah said as Nabi or as a leader. So we come now to the after. Is it before we go any comment or any question before we move to now to the Surat Hujurat? Any question, please make it as a discussion. It's not a formal class. Before I move, any question, and please. Yes. Why they? Oh yes, they were mushrikin. They were mushrikin that time, and kafir. They don't. Ma ya'budun ma na'buduhum illa liyuqarribuna ila Allah zulfa. Not because they don't believe on Allah, but they say, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَٰهًا وَاحِدًا. How can Muhammad put? Because in Mecca, in Kaaba, they have 360 gods inside Kaaba. So they couldn't believe that all this dunya are governed by Allah. They say small things are done by God, and then we are nobody to go directly to Allah. مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ. We pass through those gods to bring us to Allah. So they couldn't accept that only one Allah. So they go to these gods for these gods to bring them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Muhammad comes say la ilaha illallah, he couldn't accept the trouble. But Allah says in another surah, وَلَا إِنْ سَأَلْتَ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ. If you ask them who created you, they will say Allah. Yes. They believe on Allah, but they say, no, we cannot go to Allah directly. We have to pass through these gods. Please, any question, any comment, please. Feel free to ask anything, sisters. And before we go to you now, it was a long introduction to Surat Hujurat. Also, some people come also. If you have anything, please, any question, any comment, you can ask. So Surat Hujurat, as I say, I mentioned, is the word Hujurat Hujurat is a plural of a Hujra. Hujra is a room. And those people, as I say, Surat Hujurat was revealed in year 9. We call it Amul Wufud, year of the delegation. Because Fatu Makkah was year 8. When Makkah fell down in the end of Rasulullah in the year 8. And then year 9, Rasulullah sent Abu Bakr to perform the Hajj. Rasulullah didn't go himself. Because still Makkah, there were some idol or mushrikin, they used to perform Hajj without any bajo. Rasulullah didn't want to do that. Only Rasulullah performed Hajj year 10. So year 9, was Abu Bakr Siddiq. So year 9 was year of Amul Wufud, where all the Arab and Jazira Arabia, they have to come to Rasulullah Sallam to say they are under Rasulullah Sallam, year of the delegation.
So a tribe, they came, Ya Muhammad, start to call him instead of waiting. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Hujurat is going to give us this all are full of hukum, I think 5 or 6 hukum individually. And then, by the way, you will see Rasul Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran never mentioned name of any Sahaba. Allah didn't mention the name of any Sahaba. Many Sahaba, some Sahaba will do something. Allah never mentioned name of any Sahaba for many reasons. One, Quran is a eternal book. It's for all everyone from the time of Rasul until Yawm al-Qiyamah. So it's not talking about individual or the small detail. And then if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned name of some Sahaba, they did things when they were kafir. Imagine that Allah mentioned their name, after they become Muslim, it won't be okay. So Allah doesn't mention their name. But even Abu Bakr Siddiq, because Allah didn't mention his name. The only Sahabi Allah mentioned his name in Quran once is Zayd. فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِنَا in Surah Ahzab. Why? Why Allah didn't mention the name of even Abu Bakr, then he mentioned the name of Zayd, the only Sahabi Allah mentioned the name? Because whenever any ayah in Quran you take, ayah is talking about Abu Bakr or any Sahaba, you can put it in yourself. Quran is talking about everyone as if it was related to you today. Yeah, any ayah, just take it, you'll find it's talking to you. And so ayah of where Allah is talking about Abu Bakr, Isqali sahibihi la tahzan during Hijrah, when Allah Rasulullah told Abu Bakr was very worried, Rasulullah told him, don't be sad, Abu Bakr, inna Allah ma'ana. It can be you, it can be me, it can be any of us. You have a friend, he's in trouble, you tell him, ya la tahzan. So Quran is talking about everyone individual as if it was revealed to you today, except the ayah who mentioned the name of Zayd. He's only talking is a something, it won't be for anyone, it won't be for anyone. It's only a special case for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Zayd and Zainab. Why? You know that last year we mentioned this, my last visit here was about Surah Ahzab. We come again a bit where the Surah start about what we have in Malaysia here, very famous, the problem of Anak Angkat. And sometimes emotionally we will take a baby and then give the name. And my name today is not my baby, it's not my son, my daughter, I give my name. So it was very famous in Makkah. And the Arabs used to do this kind of thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even Rasulullah did it. And the story of Zayd, you know, Arab, one of the way to get money in the Arab society before it was to kidnap someone, like I say. But the family of Abu Dhar, Ghaffari, they were very well known about this. So, but generally, Arab, they will do this. They will kidnap someone and then sell him, and then this is how they were living. So Zayd bin Haritha was kidnapped when he was a baby, a boy, and he was sold in Makkah. So it was one of the Khadija's uncle, Rasul's wife, bought him, and after that, he gave him hadiyah to Khadija, and this is how Rasul met Zayd. So, and after long, Zayd's family come to know that Zayd is in Makkah. So they came to Makkah asking Rasulullah, please tell us whatever you want, how much you want, money, we give you to take. Then Rasulullah say, as you know, and just brief, say, okay, I'm going to ask him, Zayd, if he accept you as father, you take him free. You take him free. I'm not going to ask you money. But if he say he want me, I'm sorry, I'm not going to leave him. They were very happy and never expect that Zayd would accept Muhammad, Rasul Muhammad. That time, no Rasulullah. Because when he's a Rasul, he is with Muhammad, is like a slave. So when Rasulullah said, Muhammad says, Zayd, you know this? This man? Yes, this is my father. This is my uncle. Okay, go ahead, choose. Then he said to his father, I'm sorry, this man is someone special. I cannot go with you.
And the father was crazy, couldn't accept. He said, you want me to be slave? He said, I saw something in this man I cannot find anywhere. So Rasulullah took the hand of Zaid, go to CNN. CNN that time is the Kaaba. Went to the Kaaba and tell all people of Makkah, are you a nurse? Zaid Ibn. Zaid is my son. I'm his father. Yare Sunni or Are Su. But from that time, they call him Zaid Ibn Muhammad. Zaid Ibn Muhammad. And this is, in fiqh, is not acceptable. But we're in the time of Jahiliyyah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to, Islam, when Islam came, they are in Mecca, things going okay. They went to Medina. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to abolish this hukum. And they want to start by in the house of Muhammad, Rasulullah himself. Zainab, she became later on Ummul Mu'mineen, beautiful woman from Mecca. Rasulullah asked her to marry Zaid. Zaid, ex-slave. Of course, she didn't accept. Her brother Abdullah bin Jahsh didn't accept. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَدَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ. Any mu'min or mu'mina cannot refuse the amr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Zainab give her body. She give by force, by ta'a lillah, her body, not heart. So every day almost, gado, at home. Zaid will go and complain to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah from far, he knows the plan of Allah. He knows what is going to happen. So he will tell Zaid, keep my heart. And Allah says in the Quran, وَإِسْتَقُلْ لَذِي أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَأَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ زَوْجَكَ. Whenever Zaid comes to complain to Rasulullah about what Zainab is doing to him, Rasulullah says, Subhanallah, keep her, push. He wants to push, want to force. And because he knows that if Zaid divorced Zainab, you know what's going to happen. Just Rasulullah wanted to push only to delay. Because it's a code of a society leader. People are going to talk in the society. Oh, how can Muhammad marry his own daughter-in-law? Could they, for them, no difference between Anna Ankad or Anna Betul. No difference. So Zaid divorced Zainab, and then you are going to marry her? Oh, something strange. So in the end, Zaid divorced Zainab. And what happened? You know, of course, you know that Aisha was the number one. Eh? After Khadija, of course. Eh? So the second in beauty and young is Zainab. So Aisha say, she and me, Zainab and me, we were the two wives, the two madu, all like this. But she has a good iman, good heart. During Aisha problem in Surah An-Nur, when Munafiqin say she did blah, 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 this was, if anyone else, generally, was the moment for the madu to, see, but, you know, Zainab, when Rasulullah asked her, what she say, Ya Rasulullah, ahmi basari wa fami, ma raitu illa khair. I'm not going to say nonsense thing, Ya Rasulullah, I didn't see anything wrong. I'm not going to, she's a good woman. This is what Zainab say. After that, she become very close to Aisha. So Zainab, she was, Aisha say, she's the one and me fighting in the heart of Rasulullah salam. So when divorced Zainab, after that, Zainab will tell all the madu, Zawaja kunna ahli kunna. You, your parents are the one who married you to Rasulullah. Ama ana, me, Zawajani Allahu min fawqi sab'a samawat. Because have married with Rasulullah never happened before in Islam and will never happen until Yawm al-Qiyamah. Generally, when Mr. A, when Ilyas want to get married, Dr. Tuti and Sheikh Lim, they have to go. If she from Trengano or Sabah, wherever, they have to go there, right? But this one in Zainab and Zaid, it didn't happen. And Zaid divorced her, trust Rasulullah married her. No idda, no mahar, no nothing, direct any fax or WhatsApp from Allah to Rasulullah to marry her. So she say always to the madu, hey madu, zawaja kunna ahlikuna, your parents are the one who married you. Me, Zaina, zawajani Allahu min fawqi sab'i samawat, Allah is the one who married me to Rasulullah salam. Very special marriage. No mahar, no wait for anything. Divorce through smack any kawin. So this is the why Allah mentioned the name of Zaid in the Surah Ahzab, because this case never happened before. It was not going to happen again. So it's nothing. As I said just now, in Quran, you read any ayah, any surah, you find it's talking about you, except this ayah. It's not talking about you or me, nothing. It's talking only about Rasulullah, Zainab, and Zaid. Yes, it's not going to happen again. When anyone want to get married, your parents must go and ask for the, you can fail, you can get her. But this one is different. So this is the difference between why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't mention the name of any Sahabi in the Quran. So this Qabila or this tribe, when they came, they start to call, Ya Muhammad, Ya Muhammad, come to us. And then Rasulullah SAW came, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't accept the way they deal with Rasulullah SAW. Say, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, la tuqaddimu bayna yadayillahi wa rasuli wa taqullah. This surah, Surah Al-Hujurat, and a very short surah, is telling us about the good manner with Rasulullah SAW, and again with our boss, parent or whoever is there, and not only to Rasulullah, yes, to Rasulullah especially, because we have the hukum, the rule in Islam, say al-ibra bi umumi lafzi la bi khususi sabab. Quran is not coming for individual one by one. When it comes for this case, it for every case. So when I'm dealing with my boss, my father, my whoever is attached me, so the way how to be polite with him or with her, whatever, man or woman, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I mean, we are sitting, we want to eat, we are eating, for example. You cannot be the first to open to eat without permission. Everything the boss must start. This is what, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, la tuqaddimu bayna yadayillahi wa rasuli. Don't go first before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not with us. Now I'm with my father, my uncle, or someone, my boss, my whoever is there, attached me. The same thing I have to do. I cannot be in front of him. لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم. We have five or six instruction hukum in this surah. First, how to deal. This is two. How to deal with the boss, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم of course, and the boss, and the third one. I'm sorry to all of us in this day. We are involved in this, talking about our handphone, WhatsApp, and SMS, all this kind of thing. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu in ja'akum fasiqun binaba'in fatabayyanu an tusibu qawman bijahala wa tusbihu ala ma fa'altum nadimin. Whenever I receive a message, WhatsApp, someone, you know that now they can fabricate anything, put people photo and manipulate. Maybe, of course, even maybe I don't know the name, but you know how they can do. So whenever you receive a photo, I'm sorry to tell you, one day I went to Singapore. Of course, I attacked him, my friend, he's Malay Singaporean. Before he's married, he took the photo of his fiancée and his photo, not betul. He's holding her, kissing her, and he put in his room. This photo, but of course he didn't do it. He just make it. And I say, his name is Ismail. I say, Ismail, what is this? Well, now he married since, she's a big children. And this is, he did it himself. He put in his room, but it can be anyone else to do this, someone against him to do this and then send the photo, right? And in WhatsApp or in email. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, I told him, Ismail, don't provoke people. Don't make people talk bad about you. You know, in Sahih Muslim, in Sahih Bukhari, during Ramadan, one of Rasulullah's wife, Sophia, she went to visit him because Rasulullah was doing itikaf. She went to visit him in the masjid. And after that, we talk a bit. Then Rasulullah want to send her back. And in Bukhari, Rasulullah saw two Ansari, Sahabi. They saw Rasulullah, we say, they know, confirm this is Rasulullah. This lady, they don't know, she wearing niqab. And when they say Rasulullah, they try to cepat lari. And Rasulullah say, hey, come, ta'ata. Sophia bintu Wahab Naqab Zawjati. Rasulullah told them, it's Sophia, my wife. They say, Subhanallah, Ya Rasulullah. Say, no, Rashid. And I'm afraid Shaitan will put something in your heart. Eh? Faina Shaitan yadri. Yajri majra dam ibn Adam. Shaitan is in our blood. So, yes, later on, to confirm, this is Rasulullah. I'm not sure who is this lady. In the malam, no electric, nothing. And malam, I go and lie down. Think, this is a job of Shaitan coming now. Who is this lady? Is it one of Rasulullah's wife? Then you are now in fighting. Rasulullah wanted to make it clear. This is my wife, Sophia. Yeah. So, why someone will go and provoke people, take a lady, not yet his wife, and make him holding her? Layaju, don't provoke people. Don't make a... And again, in 89, when I left Kuwait, some of my friends, I was telling brother, I was very close to Malay student. They give me hadiah, a sarong. So because in a hostel in Kuwait, I used to wear it. I went to my country. Then I visited my uncle, Allah Yarhamu, and I wear the sarong. I wear the sarong. He came, he saw me, La ilaha illallah. He shouted on me, what is this? What are you doing this? It's nothing wrong. Even my grandfather, his father, used to wear it in kampung, in the town. They don't know this. And they don't provoke. Why he was angry to me? Because if you put one khaki outside with this, tomorrow, wallahi, you will see your name in newspaper. That Karim is a gay. Yes. Yes. People, they don't know this in my country. They don't know that. Yes. So you don't have to worry. You don't have to worry. They will say that you are gay. So don't provoke people. If someone just take a, for example, photo now, that time no, and no, and said, so take a photo and send to WhatsApp group. Mistake, blah, 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 is gay, kada. So like, for example, this is a masjid. Here, masjid. My house is here. Sorry for the example. It's a 3 kilometers, 5 kilometers. But here is a jalan of a disco and bad things. And here is normal way. Why you want to pass here to go to masjid? Pass here one day, second day, third day. Then if tomorrow people start to talk about you, oh, this man always passes here, maybe he's doing something bad there. Here is disco, there are nonsense thing here. Why don't you pass here? So we don't have to provoke people also to talk to do bad things. They can get those, they will get those, and you will get those also. Yeah. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the third ayah and the third hukum, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu in ja'akum fasiqun bin naba'in. If a bad person came bring you bad news, not good, not authentic news, fatabayyanu, sure, check face, and to see bu qawman, you receive someone WhatsApp very clear photo, Mr. A is doing this, you say like this, and they start to send to people, start to believe, and then start to fitna mushkila. Allah say fatabayyanu and to see bu qawman bija. After in the end, going to one story, and they said, Allah said, no, make sure you check first before acting. Fatabayyan on to see qawman bi jahala, fatusbiu ala ma fa'altum nadimin. The end is sorry. So, yes, I can accept that, but it's already done. So, the third hukum is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about wento ifatani. This is the first individually, and the third. The fourth hukum is there. Allah talking about we are living in the society, we are friends, school, in whatever, in kampung, maybe two family, two tribe can gather. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking us to make try to make a peace among them. And then the fourth one is Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la yaskharu qawmun min qawmin. Nobody should, no individual or family or tribe or country should mock and laugh on other because you are poor. And then the fifth one is what you call now racism. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, ya ayyuhal nasu inna khalaqnaakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnaakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu. You are all from Adam. Adam from Turab. Inna akramakum inda Allah atqakum. Inna Allah alim. These are the five topics. Quran, Surah Al-Hujurat talk about all ahkam. As I said, all Surah Madina talking about hukum only. So this Surah of Hujurat talk about six hukum. But I'm not sure whether before I go beyond this, I want to make sure you have something you want to ask, you want to put. But if you don't talk, and my battery may be finished also. Please come. Any, please feel free to ask any question, any comment, to make it. This is not class. This is a discussion between brother and sister. It's not. I like it more when. Okay, sure. And the first two ayah, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu la tuqaddimu bayna yadayllahi wa rasulihi wattaqullah. And second, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu la tarfa'u aswatakum. And when you are talking to someone older than you, father, boss, don't talk talk politely, softly. And so the two verses, I write first in Arabic and then لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي. Okay, the first we do not do anything. I hope you can read my anything before the prophet second do not raise your voice and the voice of prayer of the prophet. Of course, as I say, he's a prophet. The ayah mentioned prophet, but he's not for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's for all anyone is up to. Your boss, your father, starting by your father, do not do anything. When we sit, for example, when we sit, the one who talk first, or when we want to eat together, the one who start, all these things must be there. Your father, your uncle, your boss, don't do anything before them. And when you talk to them, make sure you talk and politely, left and low, and them. And, I will go to the third one, please. Yes, this is what I wanted to hear. So as you ask, we talk about it. Okay, coming. But we finish this one and we come. Third one. Be sure of the authenticity of any news you receive. Okay. Authenticity of any news before acting. a king based on it. On it. This is the third one. The fourth one. Yeah, you are living. Yeah, you are living. I'm on. Yeah, you are not. Yeah, you are living. Last for Komuna. Anyone should, this is the first one, should not mock. Sometimes my pronunciation is a French pronunciation, sorry. So it's not clear, mock, huh? Mock, laugh, huh? Laugh. On anyone. Anyone should not mock, laugh on anyone. Now, yes, no, before, this is the third, fourth, okay, you make this one five, because the first one is, you make reconciliation, or two people or group of people or two people group of people group of people in case of any dispute among them. Okay, this is three. So, yeah, say, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, la yaskhar qawmum, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, in ja'ak, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, wa in ta'ifatani minal mu'mina qtatalu, fa aslu baynahuma, fa in baghat ihdahuma ala al-ukhra. Then after that, say, La yaskhar qawmum min qawmin asa an yakunu khayra. Don't laugh on anyone. Because I'm whatever, I'm CEO, I'm whatever, I'm professor, whatever, I'm maybe other one is a better on in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the fifth, and then the sixth is a do not be racism. Racist. Avoid, do not be racist. All mankind are Adam children. Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakar. This ayah was revealed in Makkah. You know, when we say Makkiyah wa Madaniyah, it doesn't mean one ayah or one surah is revealed only in Makkah or in Medina. We say Makkiyah, we give the IC to any surah by the big opening of the ayah, of the surah. If the surah start to be revealed in Makkah, we say it's Makkiyah, but before Hijrah. But in one surah, you can find surah An-Nisa, is a Madaniyah, but we have some surah ayah Makkiyah inside. Because not all Quran were revealed in Makkah or Medina. We have a few ayah revealed in Tabuk, when Rasulullah went to Ghazwa, in Hudaybiyah, and one ayah was revealed in Beit Maqdis, in Palestine, Laylat Isra wal Mi'raj. So generally, 90% or 99% were revealed in Makkah and Medina. But there are a few ayah revealed here and there. So, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakari wa unta was revealed in the day of Fathu Makkah, in Makkah. When Rasulullah conquered Makkah, he asked Bilal to go to make azan. And one Quraysh, they still have a jahiliyyah thing, they didn't accept. How can you say? Muhammad didn't find anyone else except this black man to make azan. Of course, Bilal, referring to Bilal. So the ayah was revealed. Where Allah tells them, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum black, yellow, red, what is the blue, all are from Adam. So these are the six ayah in Surah Hujurat. Okay, for the first ayah, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, la tarfu aswatakum fawqa sawti an-nabi. ولا تجهلوا بقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض ان تحبط اعمالكم وانتم لا تعلمون. As I said, I mentioned just now, year 9, it was a year of a delegation where all the tribe came to Medina to make bayah to Rasulullah Sallam. So two different tribes came, and Abu Bakr Siddiq wanted Rasulullah to receive the one man, and he said to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, receive this. Now Umar, maybe he didn't hear, Umar said to Rasulullah, B. Now Abu Bakr was angry. He said, why you say different from me, different things from me, you just want to argue? And then Umar said, no, I just say it. Then they start to argue, and then they're angry. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tarfau aswatakum. Man, sure, this is, you are in with Rasulullah sallam, don't forget. This is not anyone. This is Rasulullah Sallam. When you are with him, try to. So there were one Sahabi, Qais bin Thabit. It was someone whose voice not like us. He need to make extra effort for people to hear him. So when he talked, he used to talk to Rasulullah Sallam. There's his voice. Not intentionally. I mean, for people to hear him, it must be like this. So when he heard the ayah, he went back home. Lock the door on him, he said, Khalas, I'm from Jahannam. I'm going to die. So he said, the ayah is talking about him, he said. So as a good leader, this is what we have to do. One of the hikmah of a salat in Masjid, Jum'ah or Sobo, whatever, whenever in kampung, in our place, someone always pray, we don't see him 1, 2, 3 days, we have to ask about him. This is what Rasulullah and Sahaba used to do. And Rasulullah didn't see this Sahabi, Qais bin Thabit, he asked another Sahaba, say, why? What happened to him? I don't see him. And then they say, the Sahabi say, I'm going to find news about him. So he went to see him. Then he told him, I think I'm going to be, he will go to Jahannam. Why? Because Allah, this ayah was revealed for him. Then the man went back to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, told him what he say. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, no, tell him he's from Ahlul Jannah. So Abdullah ibn Umar say, this man, we all in Medina, a kind of a jealous of him. He's among those who we see him is alive, but he working in Jannah. He's alive, but in Jannah. Because Rasulullah told us in front of everyone, we hear that Thabit ibn Qais is from Jannah. So he becomes someone different in Medina now among Sahaba. He's still alive, but he has already his visa to go to Jannah. Is it okay, brother? So any comment, any question, please feel free to ask. Not question, comment, we just discuss among us. Please. Ah, yes, another one. Ah, yes. Okay, sorry. Meaning 7. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم. أيها سوري. It is a ظن is a thing bad. And interpret, misinterpreting negatively or interpreting negatively. Someone say, Umar ibn Khattab say, this is a something difficult, nobody, yani, he say, التمس لأخيك 70 عذرا. He said, find for your brother 70 excuses. If anything happened, he said something, you had something, find for him 70 excuses. If you don't find, what you have to do? If he says something, he did something bad, you are not happy, he said, I think he did because of this. No, he did because of this. Try to find for him excuses 70 for you to don't be angry to him. To give him excuse. All of us can happen to any of us. So, but just to tell you something, experience, not good maybe. One of my friends, when I came in Malaysia for the first time in 90, he maybe is a kind of disease. He was, he will interpret everything negatively. You know, generally when, especially when in 90s, early 90s, it was still new. And when you come to Malaysia, Malay, first time they see us, maybe they will invite you to the house, or they will ask you, do you have this in your country? For them, curiosity, they want to know. One of my friends, he couldn't accept. Why you ask me? Think I die in my country? Why? It was like this. I mean, cannot accept anything, interpret everything negatively. He asking you, do you have this in your country? Just because he wants to, you came here, he didn't go there. He wants to know. So he interpret everything negatively. He just want to know. So this is or when you see me, you smile. Why you smile to me? Yes, it's strange. Why you smile? Because I'm not Malaysian. Because I'm African, you laugh. Why you don't say you smile to me because he likes me? What stop me to think like that? It's two things. He's smiling to me because he likes me. He saw me, he's happy. Oh, why you have to put it in negative one? This is so ozone. If I say he's smiling to me because when he saw me, he likes me, he's happy, I'm his brother, he want to implement the hadith of Rasulullah, all these beautiful things. And why don't you do like this? Anything, you just put it negative. You are going to be, you can't live in this dunya. So this, I'm sorry to say, this brother of mine, one day, I still remember his name, Jiran, is very rich. He told me it was a public holiday. He told me, Brother Karim, please ask all international students to come to my house, big bungalow, rich man, to come to my house to have only international students. We were in PJ. So I went to all many brothers, students. Okay. When I went to him, no, I don't want to go. These people, when they see, start too angry. I just leave him. In the end, he couldn't stay in Malaysia. Then he went to one country, Arab country. Believe me or no, he used to call us, and then he say, please kiss hand of Malaysian hand for me. Because he went to one country where when they see foreigner, they put eye on you. They take eye, and then because you are African, for especially, and it's true on you. So when you compare, when I was in Malaysia, how they deal with me, then you went to country, when they see you, you are just a, you are not from that country, or you are from African, then see you, they put eye on you. So you just say, you call and say, if you see any Malay, please kiss hand. So this is how we interpret things. So everything to put the someone say something, you put it in bed. Allah say, stop this. Generally, you're going to be wrong. Ya your nasu, is tenibu kasiran. Majority of this is thing in about the dhon is a dosa. Thank you, brother. So, any comment, any question? Huh? Let me. Yes. Huh? How many? Let me check. Let me. I hope I have a Quran. This is a new handphone for me. I just got 2 days ago. Huh? No, the surah ayah. How many ayah? No. From the beginning. Maybe you have a Quran? 18. 18. 18. So, yes, yeah, you're in the beginning. Is it before? Okay. Do you have a Quran there? Okay, good. Very good. Okay, so I will, good. Yes. Okay, this is a Surat Hujurat 18. So the first one is the one I say, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, don't do anything before the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or your parent. And then the second, don't raise your voice upon the voice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the third one, make sure of the authenticity of any WhatsApp you receive, message, any news you read anywhere. The fourth one is two people or a group of people or two tribe, two family fight is the fourth one. The fifth one, yeah, you're living, do not mock, laugh on anyone else because it's different from you or less, you think it's less on in terms of material. The sixth is the one, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu ijtanibu kathiran min adh-dhon, avoid the bad interpretation. Ya ayyuhan-nas, the seven is Ya ayyuhan-nasu, we are all from Adam. Plus. Because I jump the one, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu ijtanibu kathiran. This is seven, yes. This is seven, yes. Misinterpret any. You see me, first, I don't know you, you don't know me, I smile. Why is he smiling to me? Because, what do you think? Why don't say, why he smiles to me because he likes me? Because I'm handsome, because I'm beautiful, I'm color. Why? What is wrong? You didn't open his heart. So just be in peace, make it a positive, and then life goes. Why you have to put it in negative? Allah says, stop this. Okay? No, this is talking about some reality. Good. Okay. You know, Quran Karim is an Arabic, but it's not Arabic. When I say in Arabic, is Arabic. He was revealed in Arabic. Sahaba in the beginning also. Rasulullah, of course, didn't make the tafsir Quran all from A to Z to Sahaba. One of the reasons is if Rasulullah did the tafsir Quran, nobody has the right to come and make a tafsir Quran again. Because Rasulullah is the last. But Quran is for all and all time until everyone and all time until Yom Kiyama. And only the time make tafsir. Imagine. Can you imagine when Rasulullah told the second day after he came from Isra wal Mi'raj, he told Quraysh, I went to Palestine. Even he didn't say I went to Al Mi'raj. He said I went to Palestine. And then they know from Makkah to Palestine, Frigi Bale is 2 bulan. Frigi, 1 month, come back 1 month. And you last night you were here and you are telling me you went to Palestine and come back? Yes. Because it's beyond the akal. Something we do 2 months. You are here last night. So another ayah in Surah An-Nahl. Come with me. Surah An-Nahl is a Surah the one after before. Surah An-Nahl is the one before Isra. Surah An-Nahl, Isra wa Kahf. So Allah say in the beginning, when he's talking about the transport, okay, Surah An-Nahl is the surah, very good, 16. Allah is talking about, in the beginning, Allah say, is ayah 7, talking about the transport. Transport. How do we came from Pajam to here by what? By car. In the time of Rasulullah, what Sahaba Arab did know? Only kuda, unta, or jalan kaki, right? Allah say, listen. Allah say, wal khayla, wal bihala, wal hamira, litarkabuha. He say, khayl,
Hey, all of these are the donkey and unta, kuda. Then in the end, Allah say, وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I will create something you don't know in terms of transport. Then he didn't say what. Rasulullah didn't do the tafsir. Just leave it. And now I'm asking you, what are the transport we know and they don't know? Ah, bicycle, aeroplane, all this. So if I, now I'm with you now, here, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, and then let's say tomorrow we have a meeting again here, and tomorrow I come and tell you, oh, I'm very tired. Why tired? I was in Hong Kong, I just come back. Is something strange? No. In Hong Kong here, Hong Kong is 3 hours. I went for a meeting for 1 hour, very big meeting. I went just in airport or hotel, the car, and then I come back. Is something? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, wa yakhluqu ma la ta'lamun. I will create something you don't know. He's talking to Sahaba. And then you people now, you have an aeroplane, you have a car. And then do you think you have everything? No. You don't know that. I'm telling you, I live with this. In 2006, I was going in Kelantan in Ramadan. This madam, I met one of my old, the first ever lecturer of English in KLCC. LCCT, what's LCCT? LCCT, sorry, LCCT, and before KLI too. So she was wearing telecom, and then holding her purse in hand, only that. I was happy to see you, and then I say, what are you going? Then she said, I'm going to Kelantan, pray Tarawih with Almarhum, Tun Aziz, Sheikh Nick Aziz, and come back. She's a lecturer at UIA. What happened? Maybe she, after class, she must go and she has nothing to do. And just she click website Air Asia and she saw ticket, maybe 10 ringgit. Just bought it in 1 second. Tick, tick. Can you imagine? Go back 30 years ago, how someone will buy ticket in Malaysia. If you are not in Kuala Lumpur, if you want to buy a ticket, let's say if you are living in Negeri Sembilan, you have to go to, for example, Kuala Lumpur. It will take half day for you, from you. Take bus or susah, come and then. But now she will buy the ticket. We say in, and then one day we send my mother-in-law in KLIA. And it was that time these two people are not. So we are going back home. Wallahi, she called us. She said, that's sampai. She sampai in KB. We are not yet home. We are on the way to go back home. We are from KLIA to, that time we are seeing Jalan Duta here. So from KLIA to Jalan Kuching, she sampai Kelantan before us. So, and people in Malaysia, I was in Majalah Tiga, 45 years ago, people to go to Hajj, they will go before, some of them go before Hajj, before Ramadan. They don't want to gamble. But now, one day before the Mina, they go. So the transport meaning passing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the ayah, وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I'm telling my student, when we read this ayah, some from Sabah, Renganu, Kelantan, you come from your kampung, stay in the hostel here in Nilai. Maybe you, your children, or your chuchu, they won't need to come from kampung, Terengganu, Kelantan. They just sit at home. This is Sabah in Terengganu, in Kedah. And the way you are coming from your hostel, 10 minutes, when they have a class, 1 hour, you just come and wait for, call it what you like, aeroplane, whatever. Just maso, tick, they are in Nilai. For class, after class, they say, oh, I want to drink tea, I want to go back home. Tick, they go. So this is the meaning of وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah will create something you don't know. Something never cross your mind. See the Quraysh, they refuse that Rasulullah went to Palestine to come in one night. Now if you tell anyone, it's nothing. So Quran make its own, the time make tafsir himself. That's why Allah, Rasulullah didn't make the tafsir. So the ayah, kalimat
the word Muslim and mu'min, is it the same? Yes and no. When Allah say, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykumus siyam. Allah say, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. He didn't say, Ya ayyuha alladhina aslamu. And then you say, what is the about Muslim? So we say these are the technique of a tafsir. When the word in Quran, when the word Islam and Iman came together in the same ayah, become different meaning. No same meaning. Here, قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. Those people, delegation, they came. They just came, the kampung pion bidun, they came. They are telling Rasulullah SAW like, we become mu'min, we become. Then Allah SWT said, hey, be careful, stop this. You are not yet mu'min, just Muslim. See the meaning? Allah telling them, no need to show off yourself. I mean, exchange to say you are mu'min. You are not yet mu'min, you are Muslim. And the iman will come later on, Allah said. So here, but when Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam, it's talking about, so everyone, now we don't see the difference between iman and Islam. So iman mean here, Islam. But when he mentioned iman and Islam together, is فَخْرَجْنَا مَنْ كَانَ فِيهَا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فَمَا وَجَدْنَا فِيهَا غَيْرَ بَيْتٍ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So when the iman and Islam came in the one ayah, give this different meaning. But when one of them only came, the meaning is the same meaning. So Allah is telling the Arab here, قالت الأعراب, they say, Ya Muhammad, we become mu'min. Allah says, hey, stop. You are not yet mu'min, but you are Muslim. Just to tell that is not the same. We start by Muslim, the Shahada, and then after that, and we go they just mash Islam, those Arab become, then they are telling Rasul, we become mu'min. I say, no, wait until you become Muslim, a mu'min. So is a, no. So this is the munnuna alayka naslamuna. So, قالت العرب آمنا كلم تؤمن ولكن إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله. But we don't have to find always in Quran that when you are Muslim. Generally it's the same because you know this hadith in Bukhari when Sahaba they went to war and one enemy Usama wanted to kill him. He said La ilaha illallah. Then Usama killed him. When they went back to Rasulullah, Rasulullah didn't, I don't say forgive him, but keep on repeating, why are you killing him? He said, Rasulullah, he said it in his mulut only. And Rasulullah said, did you open his heart to see whether he's inside or no? So, this Islam and Iman all are in the end of Allah. We just judge outside. In a Muslim, he says, Muslim, khalas. Muslim, mu'min. But once Allah mentioned the boss in the one ayah, meaning is not the same. But when he doesn't mention, Muslim is mu'min is Muslim. Yeah. So, but those people, Al-Arab, and they just come and telling Rasulullah, we become mu'min, we are mu'min. Allah said, no, stop. You are not yet mu'min, you are Muslim. Because you know, this in Sahih Muslim, one of them, they have their way of when you want to ask someone a service, you ask him and politely. Anas ibn Malik said in Sahih Muslim, one day we are going, me and Rasulullah Sallam, one Arab came, and then he said, Ya Rasulullah, this is how we did. Hold Rasulullah Sallam, touched the baju of Rasulullah until he said, Anas said, I could see the trace of the Rasulullah baju here. He said, Ya Rasulullah, give me the money of Allah. It's not your money, it's not your parents' money. This is how for them is normal. And Anas said, Rasulullah turned, smiling to him. Of course, if it was me, I will. So this is how those people they were. When they come from the kampung, their way of behaving with Rasulullah was different. Any other question or commentaries? Please go to us. All questions are from brothers or shiur. Okay, please, sister. This is a maybe a bit different case. We are talking about men and men. I mean, of course, normal men, because country like here, or when you say, because now something, you cannot believe a thing. I saw some documentary in France, or any normal people, any men and men, they married, and woman and woman become like normal, like wife and husband now. Something for them is normal. And then nobody has the right to talk bad about them, they receive them like that. So, but we are talking about in a normal society, our men and men, when you see me, when you, that's why, before I answer this, Rasulullah said in Hadith of Bukhari, 7 group of people, they will be in the shadow of Allah Yawm al-Qiyamah. One of them, وَرَجُلَانِ تَحَابَّ فِي اللَّهِ. One of them, 2 brothers, love each other for Allah. اجتمع عليه وتفرق عليه. Me and brother, we are friends, we are brothers, we come. I like him for Allah, he likes me for Allah, we are always together. And someone asked, can be exactly like the question of a sister, can be man and woman? No. No. 2 sisters, yes. And, if, for example, we now, we like Sahabiyat, and Aisha, and Umm Sulaym, Umm Salama, we like them, and then we pray for them, we like them as a Sahabiyah. But if I see a woman, nice woman, is married or not married? If she's married, like Jews, you cannot in contact or tell her, and we book fila. Because Rasulullah was sitting with one Sahabi, one Sahaba passed, he said, Rasulullah, I like him. He said, you told him? He said, no. He said, go and tell him. You must tell him when you like your brother, and we book fila. I like you for Allah. And then he has to say, Habak Allah, he will pray for you again. For you. But if someone likes a woman, should he tells her, no. Jews, he cannot tell her, and she cannot tell him. If she's married, she's not married. If you really want to approach her, you know what to do in a halal way. If you know she's married, full stop, finish. So this comment just now, smiling. This is between me and him. I see him smile. If a woman, she working somewhere on Colombo, whatever, she saw someone as a human being, she just smiled past. I'm not going to see him again. He's not going to see him. I smile to him, pass away for say salam. But if you are working in the same place, always smiling like this, maybe it's better. We have to be careful. I mean, I can, if I'm a woman, I can do it if I think
balance
that nothing in his heart. I cannot confirm it. I'm married, sure, I'm not going to do. I just smile as a colleague or friend. I'm not going beyond that. Okay, but to go more like this, if me, as a woman, I suspect that something in his heart and I'm married, I can stop. Or I can show him something that no way for you. But cannot be like, just now we mentioned, Rulama, I can tell him I like you as a brother, I cannot tell her I like you for Allah. No way. No way. So she has to balance where if she knows that is an ikhlas, nothing in his heart, or he won't go beyond that, I can smile to him as a friend, as a colleague, as a whatever. But if I start to smile something on him, and if I'm married, then I have to stop. I have to change. I have to show him something. This is what I can answer. Yeah, friendly. That's why I say we have to balance. If I'm coming here, maybe we meet only once a week. If I'm not married, I can be a bit different from if I'm married. I mean, I'm coming with my husband, for example, and we are smiling to people, to men and women, whatever, and then go. I mean, of course, Aisha used to receive a sahaba, but of course, maybe I don't be like this, no. Smile, normal smile, and but not going beyond. You know better the type of a smile, of course. So I can smile to boys and girls as a way of a salam. And smile normal, I say salam and smile, but go beyond, then she knows better. Rasulullah SAW said in hadith, istafti qalbaka, when after can I ask yourself. And I smile to him, he has something in his heart or no, she should know better. She should know, she's not a little girl, and she should know, is it the 100% ikhlas or something in his heart. If I'm not married, we can open. If I'm married, she should know. I mean, if I'm coming with my husband, I smile to him, no problem. I mean, he's there, we go back home, and halas. And I hope you are, this small thing, she should know herself. He's smiling, is something in his heart or no? She should not understand this, she's a balance. I hope I answer you. We are friends, we meet here, we smile at this, and there must be a limit. Must be a limit. Not open in Western way, and then we know generally how we finish. And we know generally when they smile, how it's finished. So we in our society, generally is a conservative way. It's open but conservative. We smile, it doesn't mean we have to be like this. We smile, but you don't go beyond. If you don't smile, they will reject you, but of course you smile, you have to have a limit, especially if woman, if woman. I hope this is clear. Any, I don't know, where are we now? Oh, okay. Okay, so any question, please? Any question, brother? If any question, please feel free. Hello, thank you. There is a kind of a not sha'ir, one of Arab poets, they say Nazaratun. Things start, relation between men and women, they say Nazaratun. Start by me, Fabtisamatun, smile, Fasalamun, after smile, Fasalamun, salam, after that, Kalam, talk, then, Faliqa, Famawid, and then, meeting, I want to see you, Famawidun, Faliqa, I want to see you tomorrow or next week, so come by. Step by step. That's why Allah said in the Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, la tattabi'u khutuwati shaitan. Allah didn't say, do not follow shaitan. He said, khutuwati shaitan. Steps of shaitan. Shaitan is a professor, very pandai. There's a time. He never come to anyone to say, do this. He will come by step. And in the end, and then you know the Ibn Kathir make a tafsir of a the surah, ayah in surah al-Hashr, كَمَثَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِسْقَالَ الْإِنسَانِ أُكْفُرْ. You see, Ibn Kathir is mentioning in his tafsir, you see in the time of Bani Israel, three brothers, they have one sister, they were doing business, they want to go somewhere, and then the kampung people not very good, but they don't want to bring the girl, and then they don't want to leave her alone. And there's one sheikh, Abid, He went to see him. Can you take care of my our sister? In the beginning, he refused. No, no, no. So they force him, please. He accept. Then they leave the girl with him. Then she was sent up, he down. Never see her, never talk to her, never. And after long, Shaitan came to him saying, you pretend you are a good man, you are kada kada. Why don't you talk to her? What is wrong? And he used to cook and then put down, and then she will come and take. Then Shaitan said, you don't have heart, really. This girl, she has to come. Why don't you put in front of her door? He put in front of the door. In the end, he said, why don't you talk to her a bit? He talked to her. And then in the end, he make a marcia with her, and she was pregnant. And when she gave birth, he killed her and he killed the baby to close everything. When the brothers came, he told her, he told them, I'm sorry, your sister missed you too much. She was crying, sake, she doesn't want to makan, and she died. They didn't doubt 1 second, they believed him. And after that, the youngest dreamt the whole story. And then he told the brother, they didn't believe him. After the dream of it, and then they went to the man, they pushed him until he said the truth, then they brought him to the mahkama, then he was Jesus, he has to be killed. In the end, Shaitan came to him, he said, this is Ibn Kathir mentioned, he said, I'm the one who pushed you to do all this. If you believe on me, I will save you. If no, you are going to die. Then he said, if you believe on Shaitan, I'm sorry, so he died kafir. So the moral of the story is that Shaitan never come to someone to say, do this. He will come slowly, slowly, slowly. That's why this Arab in poetry say, Nazaratun, start by, I make contact. Fa Isamatun, smile. Fa Kalamun, talk. Fasalamun, hi, and slowly, slowly, slowly. So we are much, we know which kind, generally, which kind of smile is this? Of course, because I cannot be in the society, say, I don't talk to men or women, I don't smile to them, I be like this. People will reject you, of course. So I smile to her or to him, but we have our limit. We have a limit of that smile. Like ulama say before, I mean, when there is no handphone, if someone called the house phone, the wife, she knows that it is the phone, it's not mine, she take the phone. Then the husband tell her, she has the right to talk or no? They say, yes, she talk. But I'm sorry, huh? No need to say, hello. No, talk like this, your husband are there? No. Salaamu alaikum, don't go extra. And this is what the ulama, she can answer or not. So all these small, small details, the woman, she knows where to go, what to do. And Allah said, bal insanu ala nafsihi basira. You know better yourself. So this is what I can answer. If any other comment or question, please feel free. Yeah, please. Uh-huh. So, Hujurat. Thank you. Rasulullah in the hadith, this is very heavy a bit. We are going to finish with a bit of sadness. Rasulullah in the hadith, Atadruna man in Muflis. Do you know who is the Muflis, the bankrupt in hadith in Bukhari? They say, Al Muflis minna, man la dirham la wala mata. Is the Muflis, the bankrupt, is the one that doesn't have money, nothing. Fala Rasulullah, Al Muflis min ummati, a Muflis among you, man ya'ti yawm al qiyamah. The one who came Yom Al-Qiyamah, this Salat, Zakat, Saum, is everything complete. What we do normal. وَيَأْتِي قَدْ شَتَمَ هَذَا وَضَرَبَ هَذَا. He beat this one, he makan the money of this one. وَأَكَلَ مَالَ هَذَا. And then we talk about, so this kind of thing. Allah, then everyone will go to Allah. Allah, he did this to me, he took my money, so you have to pay. Since there is no money, I'm going to take from the pahala of the person, give to him or her, and when it's the pahala finished, the queue still long, then they will take the dosa, put on him, and then in the end, in Jahannam. So, Rasulullah, you know the hadith of this Ma'is, one Sahabi who committed zina. He came to Rasulullah after he forced Rasulullah to make the had on him. When he was killed, when he died, Rasulullah had two Sahaba talking. See, what is this stupid man? Why Allah cover you? He's still coming to kill yourself like see something bad. Rasulullah didn't say anything. He heard them talking, both of them. Until they sampai somewhere where they were one dog or one animal died. Then Rasulullah told them, both of them, turun, makan this. They say, ya Rasulullah, ghafarallah laka, may Allah forgive you. How can you eat this one? They say, Rasulullah, tadi, what you say about that man is worse than this. This dog, mati. So we are eating our, so this is what I can say about this. Talking about people, talking about each other. So what the ulama say, there is no tawbah for that. It's for we stop and should I go and talk to him? Yeah, I used to talk bad always about him. Now I regret, I want to stop, I stop. Should I go and talk to him to ask him to forgive me or no? The majority of ulama, they say better no, because you have to balance. If I go, because I was doing this long ago, he didn't hear. If I go and talk to him now, I will make him more angry. He can be angry to me and beat me or be sacked himself. So what you have to do, make a banya dua for him. And wherever you talk bad about him, when you are sitting, you always talk good about him. This word is much better than to talk to him. You talk always good about him, you dua for him, whatever it is. Yes, and be close to him. Make him, if he died, if he's not alive, but if he's alive, wherever you were talking bad about him, if you talk like they say, Arab before Jahiliyyah, one Shaykh could bring the tribe up. Then one shaykh can be the tribe down. So if I used to talk, I talk bad about him in book or in newspaper, I mean the same thing, opposite. When I talk about him in newspaper, in book, talking good about him. But we don't go and talk to tell him I did this to you. We'll make him more sad. He can beat you. He can be sake. So we don't, generally, we don't tell him. But we stop, dua for him, be good to him, talk good about him, and that. See, this is of the human now, talking about each other, bad. This is very sad. So any sister, you have any question, please? Have any comment? Please. Huh? Are you... Why the title of we have the ulama ulum Quran as the name of a surah is given by Rasulullah or Sahaba. The majority of Sahaba ulama say is a tawqifi. The tawqifi is from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How you know that the Quran didn't come once, or Surah to Baqarah didn't come once? It's a 10 years. And one ayah revealed in Surah Al-Baqarah start to reveal to Rasulullah Sallam, and then tomorrow another surah came. So how the Sahaba knows? So when the another surah ayah came in the previous surah, Rasulullah Sallam will call the Sahabi, he say, write this ayah in the surah who mentioned Hujurat. Rasulullah mentioned the name of something in the ayah or surah. So this is how the name of the surah came. Then Rasulullah said, "Da hadi ayah, the surah leti
the surah which mentioned kata Baqarah, Ali Imran. So they will mention. This is how the name of the surah came. Thank you, sister. Again, so I think Jiresh will make it informal. We are here for some time. If anyone has something, you can ask. So I think we'll stop here. And Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Shadan la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al mursalin. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Thank you very much for all of you for your time listening.